does for me is it doesn't give her flavor. Jason Silva's link call, house's word description.
To the world, I was the star of Brain Games, a television program that inspired millions of people around the world.
Where did your sense of curiosity, could you know where it came from?
I was able to achieve fame at a young age. I had money and influence. I started to feel the burden and the pressure to stay relentless and continue to succeed. I started suffering from panic attacks and anxiety attacks, and I understood that to regain my connection to inner peace, I was going to have to face my fears. I was going to have to understand what makes me happy. Moved by this, I decided to go on a personal search of sorts to the island of Aruba, which is known as the Happy Island. So this is a kind of spiritual quest for me to understand what it is that makes Aruba such a happy place. And I was going to explore through the four elements, through water, through earth, through air, and through fire. We've already discovered how Aruba and the happiness of its inhabitants are related to three elements. But today we will discover a fourth element, one that is rooted in creativity and passion and transformation. I am talking about fire. So through my relationship and my meeting with these artists, with these diverse ways in which they use fire as a tool for transformation and renewal, I hope that it can mirror and inspire my own desire for transformation and my own need to burn away what no longer serves me. Join us. So, friends, fire, of course it destroys, but from destruction can come creation. And so fire becomes a great metaphor for transformation. And I think that transformation is necessary to have a life filled with joy and with happiness and with growth. We need constant transformation. And this is the idea that is explored in the art of Natusha. Natusha is a performance artist whose work is intensely connected to fire, alchemy, and transformation. Very excited. What a smile.
Hey, Natusha. I can't avoid it.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Nice to finally meet you, Jason.
Pleasure.
Wow. You look radiant.
Thank you so much.
And this place is pretty radiant too.
Where Isn't it? We're actually corner of dreams. Me and this island, we go way back, feel. We have an ancestral connection. We have a certain way of being with each other that has always dragged me back. So many times I left because, you know, you try to transgress the boundaries of what contains you. I went to Amsterdam, did art school. And once I was in London, I was doing a MA in performance making. I was literally called back to touch. To engage again with textures. I miss the textures of the island. So the project Caricia, which means caress,
stirred
up, and I came back to caress the island. And the caress would become a dance, and the dance would become an incantation, a song, and the song would allow a portal to open. My work lives in between the realm of art making, but also spaces of healing and remembrance. I've been making for life. Life. Life is happening
life
to me.
Life comes through you.
So we're gonna go through a little practice, a little ritual with three steps, which is to caress, to hold space for touch, for textures to inform how we trace. and allow that movement to transmute or transform into a song. And we're gonna use the element of fire, which is the element of transformation. It's the element of movement. Letting go of?
Yeah, letting go of fear.
Letting
go of doubt. Letting go of anxiety. The power of letting go so that something new can be born, right? I'm feeling an energy here of a free woman, a free spirit.
Thank you. Give it all back to the fire.
If it's okay with you, I'd love to get a photo of you.
Of course.
Beautiful. Well, that was amazing. Natusha is an extraordinary woman. I appreciate the willingness to march to the beat of her own drummer and this wonderful capacity to bring the sacred to the doorstep of every moment. Many people live half asleep. They live in the default world. They fetch water and chop wood, and they are blind to the miraculous that exists everywhere, but not Natusha. She is alive in a way that we all deserve to be, and she's an inspiration. I'll stay here all day, don't worry about me.
Well, I'm getting to the end of my journey. But of course, I could never leave Aruba without meeting the famous Ciro. Everyone raves about him. He is an emblematic artist and sculptor. Ciro uses all kinds of materials in his work, and then uses the transformative power of fire to revitalize and transform his artistic expressions. It's really amazing.
Welcome at Terra Fuse. Bienvenida.
Thank you so much. Arian, nice to meet you.
Hey, Jason.
Ciro, I've heard so much about you.
So this is one of the parts?
Oh, cool.
So it's cool. A place where the most of the ideas get formed.
Okay, incubation.
Incubation, yes.
And you also do some of your
art
here.
Yes, I have my part on that side, yeah.
How cool.
We teach classes, we do workshops in glass, yeah.
Oh, you guys are so cool. Yeah. Life and death, right?
Life and death, absolutely, yeah. This is inspiration.
Yeah.
The angels also.
Yeah, Ciro worked on the angels. Mm-hmm. So he did them different ways.
This one is playing music.
This one has a different instrument.
This one has an instrument of, shall I say, death?
Yeah.
Not happiness.
Yeah, no.
This one is an instrument we're doing. We're exploring happiness. We want this one. Why does that sound like a volcano?
Heat in the top until it's red.
I can see.
Red hot. See? Takes a while.
If it's not hot enough, it would not stick on the glass.
You're simulating creation, right? Because it's only at those extreme temperatures that Earth creates stuff.
Yeah. This heats up the glass up to 700 Celsius.
So I would love to hear about your story. How did you get started with making art?
It was in 69, 70.
Yeah.
I did collect insects.
Interesting.
And I cast them in polyester. So okay. You get a block.
Yeah.
And polish it very transparent. So you see, it start blending the two of the of these materials. Why not using these materials for something else, to create something else?
That's interesting.
Because before that, in high school, I was always fascinated by the story of also schoolmates about what they found. They found like chisels from prehistoric chisels and pieces of potteries and so on. I was very curious about that part too.
Is this the moon lander?
It's the moon lander. It's from my youth.
What is your relationship between making art and happiness? Are you a person that found happiness through art?
Surely, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, because it gives a certain satisfaction in the way you original ideas you have, and the dreaming with that idea, giving it a form, giving it a body.
I've seen a sculpture garden, I've seen all this art. What was your intention when you created this place, this meditation circle, the sculpture garden? Yes. What was your hope?
As a part of a piece we want to share with other artists and with the tourists and with everyone. That was the plan. And the plan is also for me to try to integrate the art what I made, because that's a connection also in my work with the First Nations.
Right.
So that's the
cool.
The meaning.
You're touching upon something that's uniquely human, which is our capacity for imagination,
yes.
and the profound need to express our imagination, and when we do that, we become artists. Anytime you can imagine and then you can create what you imagine, you're an artist. Not all humans get the opportunity to put that into practice, but you did.
Absolutely. And only time will tell where you will be and what you become later.
Right. I know that expression.
This one is Flight Interrupted. Also, it's another bronze I cast myself here with a piece of a pre-Columbian shard.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel when people are moved by your art?
Difficult.
Yeah. Beautiful soul, man. Beautiful soul.
Because this was one of the first work I made after my wife passed away.
Oh. Wow. I'm sorry. Wow. Well, I'm sure that she would have found it beautiful.
I think so, yes.
Yeah, people are touched by your art. That must feel good.
You're right.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you. All right. Beautiful.
You know, there are few ways of engendering happiness that are as powerful and potent as joining together to share a meal. Cooking is transformative. Cooking is a ritual of celebration and feast, all things that are associated with happiness. For Natalie, fire is how she turns food into something artful, beautiful, and an excuse to bring people together.
Hey, you.
Hello, Jason.
Hey, nice
How
to meet
are
you.
You. Welcome.
Thank
nice
you
to finally
so
meet you.
Much.
Happy to have you.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you.
Tell me, is it the first time to Aruba?
It is not my first time. I used to come here as a kid when I lived in Venezuela.
Oh, wow.
And I have great memories of like riding jet skis with my dad here and like chasing the blue lizard.
I have never seen any type of lizard like that in the world. That turquoise is exquisite. It's one of my favorite. So I was born here. I lived here till I was about 12 and left when I was in 85, I think, something like that, yeah. So I've dabbled and dabbled around the world. And you know when the time changes? You go to work and it's dark and you come back and it's dark. I really got depressed, first time in my life. I was in Dublin.
Dublin,
and
okay.
I lived in the winter for 36 years.
Yeah.
It was really, really strange. And I'm like, okay, I think I need a break. I was dreaming and I could see the blue skies. I mean, these skies are gorgeous.
Yeah.
I never get enough. And said, okay, I'll stop at my home in Dublin. I came home. And it is my best life because I am home. And as an adult, as a grown adult, I started my business at 46 years old. with zero experience, zero money.
Right, so tell me about your relationship with food.
Oh, I love food.
Yeah.
I live for food.
Okay.
Food is life.
Uh-huh.
Food is, yeah, the source of energy. And we have amazing food in Aruba. Hey, let me look at these babies. Oh, they're gorgeous.
Those are the chestnut that we harvested today.
Oh, I have loads of little producers. We have a lot of young kids that moved abroad, studied, and they learned how to cultivate all these amazing things in small spaces. And I have my fishermen. These men fish for a living. And they're wonderful. You have to see how they live. But they don't live where I buy my fish, but they hang out there. They're like me. Like, I live here, literally. I sleep elsewhere, but I'm here all day. I like it. And these guys, they hang out at a pier, and they're all buddies. So you have your boat, you need help in your boat, they come and help you. I need help in my boat, they come and help me.
Are you happy?
When I go to my farmers, to my fishermen, it's a whole different world because it's not nobody. When I'm here, this is my home. And when I'm with my fishermen, they don't look at anything. It's simplicity, and you look at the water and you hear the sound, it's wonderful. So, am I happy? Yes. Work in progress? I think we all are every day. But I still have the challenge, you know, of the overachiever.
Do you improvise?
All the time.
Yeah.
This is my theater.
Beautiful.
Food is about colors and textures. Great. When I'm behind there, it's all good.
So it's pure creativity, pure creation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Fire destroys and creates.
In my case, it creates something beautiful. And then the satisfaction of seeing somebody eating your meal, and it's like, oh yeah. And being happy and knowing that.
So you get happiness from making other people happy.
Yeah.
You cook for them, you transform food, you create a work of art. They bring it into their bodies. That makes you happy.
And then when you see empty plates, that is happiness. And it's not a narcissistic happiness. It's like, okay, you created something with a family recipe and everything is gone.
Now I want to see you in action.
Oh dear. No pressure at all.
No pressure.
Necesito pimentón rojo, ajo. Yo no trabajo con guantes. Déjame lavar mi mano.
Wow, look at that fish.
Pargo rojo.
Red snapper. Mira qué belleza, huh?
And fresh fish doesn't smell. I cleaned her before you came. Scales. I have some nice julienne red pepper.
She's a master. Natalie. Well, Natalie is pure fire. It was really interesting to listen to her journey, a journey that took her across the world, a journey that took her to a dark night of the soul, a journey that took her from a breakdown to a breakthrough where she returned to Aruba, connected really with her life's passion and her life's purpose. Her story around food, around cooking, around transformation, around alchemy, around colors. She really treats cooking like an art, like a form of self-expression. You can feel the passion in her swagger and how she communicates, her relationship with her suppliers. It just feels so artisanal, so mom and pop, so much love, so natural, sustainable, balanced, harmonious. And now she's one of the happiest people I've met on this trip. So I'm really grateful for that connection. So Natalie, where are we going? I know this place. That looks like Ciro's house.
It is.
Is this the vibe? Is this the vibe? Okay.
Don't you just love it?
Have you heard of surprise?
Hey, welcome.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. My friend.
Thank you.
Ven más cerca, mi familia. Sabor, sabor.
I feel like Harold would share something.
This experience was very unique and was very profound also and authentic. That's what I told you a couple of times, you know, it's really authentic what you do. And it was nice to have connected with you and, you know, now sitting with everybody here. So it was an awesome experience. So thank you for that.
The beauty is that I was aware that, wait a second, it's actually knocking on my heart and trying to tell me something. And that's when I really grabbed it and said, this is going to be my tool and this is my gift to translate whatever I need to process or, you know, bring across my message.
I think that's what makes Aruba so special, is the openness that we have to any type of person willing to go above and beyond what they thought they could go to. And if you look at the racial profile that we have at this table, I mean, this exactly what Aruba is.
Simple dish. Mm-hmm. We have jampao. Jampao is a grouper. Okay. We only work with fresh fish. Mm-hmm.
Buen appetit.
Wow, buen appetito, huh?
We're blessed to be able to live in a tiny island like this that offers so much.
Yeah.
You know, in nature, in people, in character. I am proud to be an Aruban.
Mm. We're growing, we're aging, we're going through all of the cycles, and I think that is what we have to ritualize. We have to constantly go through a rebirth. The sun goes up and then it dies, and it is the core of life.
Every project is in the beginning very vague.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like a stardust somewhere up there. And once I start working on it, it's like you can kind of grab it more. Estrella
rondonando isla. See the nature that we have in Aruba and get close to it and like just, it's amazing to be in the water and to just, yeah. And so I'm stuck. I can never leave Aruba.
Thank you for the ecstasy. Thank you for the grace, for the smiles, for the gratitude. I truly appreciate it. And just feeling so much love, guys. Cheers.
Thank you so much.
Beautiful.
Thank you. Bravo.
This brings me to the end of my journey, the end of my search. And I suppose after examining happiness from the inside out and through the elements, in the end, friends, no man is an island, and happiness is most enjoyed in community. Happiness, it turns out, is better when it's shared. And that is the Blue Lizard Effect.
You are never here.